I think it's really brilliant to have a conference where you've got everyone from, you know, people at the World Health Organization to the policymakers to the regulators and actual startups that are coming up with innovative and novel ways of tackling antibiotic resistance, and then investors and funders all in one place.
As WHO, we are going to present our work on assessing the pipeline, looking into the preclinical pipeline, but also we will present a possible idea for another impact investment fund to actually finance phase 2 and 3 clinical development.
The reason for us to want to do an antibiotic company, so all your
at the end of the day, there's significant unmet medical need, and we think there is opportunity over time to create value by investing in commercial clinical development of anti-infectives.
Well, this is the first year that the conference is going to include a topic on data and surveillance and how that can help early stage companies develop and target their products better. So we'll be talking about surveillance and the types of work that BD does to help smaller companies focus their antibiotic development efforts.
We answer the big questions: are your bacteria living or are they dying from the acid?
These are assays used in the Western Scottish virology and bacteriology. I've never heard of such assays.
We
grow free of
finger.
If we were to try to find some of these more long term, but other than that, there are no.
It is a difficult economic market for antibiotics at the moment. We're patient investors. We're a private institution with a very long investment horizon, and that is really what is enabling this for us. And we also think that investing is helpful to the ecosystem in that we're all going to strive for profit, because profit is really what's going to turn around the economic sustainability of the space.
I'm really, really happy to see how this AMR conference is developing throughout the years, with more and more relevant people, key opinion leaders, regulators, policymakers also joining this battle. And I think we're going to win this battle if we stick together and we really have more opportunities like this conference to gather and brainstorm and ultimately implement the urgent actions that we need in this field.